The Center for Family Life, which is a program of SCO Family of Services, was started in 1978 by two sisters of the Good Shepherd. And the original idea was to work with people here in Sunset Park, Brooklyn, around gang prevention and working with people that were having child welfare issues. So now we advance 30 plus years where we have about 9 different programs all around Sunset Park community. And one of those is the worker-owned cooperative program. A lot of the immigrants that live here in Sunset Park were already working in very bad conditions, doing domestic work, working in factories, in restaurants. So the ability to kind of work collectively and start your own business and manage it and work in it really was very empowering. So Beyond Care Childcare Cooperative started in 2009 in June. We began by providing for them a 12-week curriculum that focuses not only on developing the business structure, but also developing their skills as child care workers. They began with 19 founding members who were all immigrant women here in Sunset Park and have now opened up the co-op about 3 to 4 times and are now 42 members. So they've been really successful at getting more clients and just being very well known and respected in the child care community.
Una cooperativa es un grupo que se forma en la comunidad para tener empleos mejores, salarios justos, tengamos una flexibilidad en los trabajos y tenemos un contrato para que respeten nuestras horas, nuestras vacaciones y tengamos beneficios formados por la comunidad prácticamente y en el grupo de la cooperativa.
Porque cada una es dueña de su propio trabajo y tenemos, nos organizamos más y tenemos una relación en la cooperativa con cada una de las miembros.
The way that Beyond Care is structured is that they are a marketing cooperative where each member that belongs to the co-op pays a membership due to use the benefits of it. So the publicity that everybody does collectively means that the jobs that come in to the cooperative, they all have an equal chance at getting access to those interviews and jobs. So all of the members are required to attend all of the meetings, which happen once a month. The membership meetings where all the decisions take place. They're also required to do 3 hours of publicity per month where they go out and distribute brochures and they go to street fairs and blog and do different kinds of things to advertise their business. And they also have different committees. So they have a leadership committee with a president, vice president, secretaries, and treasurers. They have a publicity committee, a training committee, and an office committee. And so they delegate all the different roles that are really important to those people. And the elections happen once a year, so everybody has a chance to participate in these leadership roles.
Hemos tenido entrenamientos sobre pediatría básico, nutrición, primeros auxilios y cómo tratar a bebés de diferentes edades. Me han ayudado mucho, algo que antes no sabía. A pesar de que tengo 3 hijos, es mucho porque son diferentes entrenamientos que hemos tenido y me han ayudado muchísimo.
I came across the co-op and I was 100% interested in what they were doing after going to their website and seeing what they were doing and how they got organized, and it kind of fit my idea of what I would want in a nanny, someone who was very active in their own life. I didn't even know going into this hiring that home care workers were not given the same sort of labor rights as any other worker in the state or in the country. She was the first one I interviewed. And I didn't need to interview anyone else. She came with phenomenal qualifications, extremely professional.
The cooperative businesses have been a really interesting model to use because people before joining the cooperative faced a lot of exploitation, wage theft. They were working isolated in homes, often doing domestic work. So when they gather to form these collective businesses, they're able to basically create standards for themselves. For example, have contracts that they present the clients. They can have price lists that they are able to negotiate collectively.
Ha cambiado mi vida totalmente. Porque yo de trabajar 8 o 10 horas en un supermercado por un sueldo tan mínimo, ahora yo lo que podía ganar en una semana, tal vez ahora lo puedo ganar en 2 días. Entonces, ha sido fabuloso. He crecido, también me he educado más, he aprendido más. Mis hijos se han dado cuenta. Lástima que ahora mis hijos son ya demasiado grandes y que no puedo desarrollar las tácticas, lo que he aprendido en ellos. Pero realmente estoy muy feliz y como persona me ha servido mucho la cooperativa porque he crecido, pienso en grande ahora, pienso en el futuro, en qué podré hacer en el futuro, tal vez cuando me retire podré poner mi propio daycare, puedo hacer cosas, ayudar a otra gente para que siga incorporándose en cooperativas y pensar en grande en el futuro. Esto es algo fabuloso, estar en una cooperativa, es muy, muy recomendable.
The other co-ops that we've been very fortunate to work with in the last few years are Si Se Puede Women's Cleaning Cooperative, which is actually the first co-op that we started working with back in 2006. They've been extremely successful at growing their business and have now started thinking about new projects and helping others to develop co-ops. There's also Golden Steps Elder Care Cooperative that's newer. It started in 2011 with 20 immigrant women as well, and they provide non-medical companionship care for the elderly.
Cada una tiene su propia opinión. Cada una tiene opiniones diferentes y a veces varias coinciden y varias no. A veces estamos de acuerdo, porque en esa me incluyo yo, y a veces no. Pero hay que respetar las opiniones y las decisiones del grupo. Principalmente el beneficio para la cooperativa, no para cada una de nosotras, ¿no? Es para la cooperativa, porque la cooperativa somos todas.